Hello, my name is Amin Neal, and I'm going to be explaining a little bit about the Nyiragongo eruption in 2002. So Nyiragongo is located in Africa, in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, and it sits upon a large rift in between two plates that are constantly spreading apart. And this rift is responsible for most of the volcanic activity that Nyiragongo is actually experiencing, and sort of the reason why ex eruptions are so deadly. And this eruption occurred January 18th, 2002. So why did the eruption occur? Essentially, the rift that Nyiragongo sits upon causes a lot of magma to rise and build up, a lot of pressure, which could lead to an eruption at any point in time, or like any earthquake could set it all off. But what's different about this specific eruption was that the rift experienced a sudden widening. It very quickly got larger, which set off a huge explosion and caused all sorts of problems. So here you see some of the problems I was talking about. The reason this was so deadly was because due to the political unrest of the country, monitoring the volcano wasn't really a priority, and there really weren't any emergency protocols or any sort of aid that could have been given out. Sort of, they were lacking a proper emergency response. And during the initial eruption, at least 45 people died. 14 villages were destroyed. Lots of homes were also destroyed. Many were too impoverished to really rebuild their houses, as many people had to evacuate, around 400,000. But many of these areas that they evacuated to were very unsanitary, causing widespread disease. And eventually, a lot of people sort of started to return to those areas looking to get some more aid and help, by which they did not fully receive, causing around 350,000 to actually be de very dependent on this aid. And you see here in this top picture, sort of people sort of trying to rebuild. This is actually a more recent picture, not from the 2002 eruption, but it's still a problem today. See here in this bottom picture, the lava flow is very thin, showing really fast, more dangerous, more easily to get caught in, more entrapped. And see in this bottom picture, the city of Goma actually being split in two. The big impact of the city there, lots of houses were gone, and many people could not sort of return. And this eruption had some very massive global effects. With the initial eruption, it released tons and tons of noxious fumes and gases, which added on to the greenhouse effect, and still adding on to the atmosphere today just because of that rift. It makes it so active. A lot of this gas and the fumes. In non-windy areas cause a lot of deaths as well, just because of how toxic they are to humans. And they eventually turn into acid rain, which affects plants and crops and livestock, which affects farmers and their productivity, and affects people who would take those crops, purchase those and everything like that. Cities and towns were covered by with the lava. You see the roads here, absolutely destroyed. And water quality in the area as a whole was just decreased. Very substantially. Lots of difficulties actually living in the area. So some lessons to take from this eruption 20 years ago. Basically, having much more consistent, uptight, more strict monitoring of this of volcanoes in the area as a whole, just because of how catastrophic this eruption was, and actually having proper evacuation methods in place and being able to put out emergency response and aid, especially for the people in that area, just because they have nowhere else to go, essentially. And if possible, sort of finding a way to combat these fumes and the acid rain, which is ruining people's livelihoods and their sort of livelihood. These are my sources. I have all my other sources under the pictures. And thank you very much for your time. I hope you learned a lot about Nyiragongo as a whole and the Great Rift in Africa. Have a wonderful rest of your life.